There are different types of back surgery, which Dr. Pazionis, I'd like you to chime in on. Let's take this graphic real quick and walk through it. Maybe you can also tell me which one is the most common one, but take the first one for us.
Okay, so there's several different kinds of back surgery. So diskectomy, laminectomy, fusion, and artificial discs are four broad categories that would happen for a patient who presented with a herniated disc, for example, and with either back pain or leg pain. The type of surgery we select oftentimes depends on patient's symptoms. So if you have back pain, that more pushes us towards a fusion. Back pain comes from either the discs or the facet joints.
And I think we're going to take the 3D image. Let's show that to our viewers right now. And let's see exactly what you're telling us in terms of that surgery. And do we have that?
Are we
ready to take that graph? That 3D image up, there we go.
Okay,
so doctor,
perfect.
Why don't you tell us what that is?
So if we look at this, so here we have our disc, okay? So this is a disc. This is the back part of your spine, so your spinous process is back here. And these are part of your facet joint, okay? So these are the joints that are in the back. Here we have the cauda equina, okay? And this is essentially what causes the nerve roots to kind of come down and then they branch out. And here is an L4 nerve root. And that's a nerve root that comes out from in between the discs and the bones in your back. So a surgery that would be appropriate for this patient that we see in the graphic, for example, would be something like a microlaminectomy and a microdiscectomy with the goal of decompressing this nerve, because the most common symptom this patient would be complaining of is leg pain. So that would be pain that's coming from the nerve and shooting down the leg. So the sciatica, as we talked about before.
Mm-hmm.
If this patient also had back pain, it could be because this nerve certainly is affected, and that would more cause leg pain. But the back pain would more be because the disc is damaged and the bones are rubbing against one another. So as we have patients who have arthritis in their hips and knees, and we all know somebody who's had a hip replacement or a knee replacement, your back certainly can also get arthritis. And once it's bone on bone, that can be very, very painful. And that's something that a fusion can help you with.